ItsJMomo here. If you watched my first attempt at locking, you might recall this top that I picked up from the thrift store. Now, I picked it up because of the embroidery on the front, but I never really quite liked the fit of it, so I finally decided what I wanted to do with it, and I'm going to show you how to turn an existing top into a halter top. So get your scissors ready, and let's jump right into it.
To make this top, you'll need a shirt, a second fitted shirt for reference points, some sort of trim, a marker, a ruler, and your basic sewing tools. Trim your shirt to the desired length. Mark 3 inches from the center front. Use the second shirt to mark the underarm point and connect to the 3-inch mark. I raised my underarm point by 1/2 inch, but this is optional. Draw a straight line down to the hem to create the side seam. To create a better fit against the body, curve out the armhole, but not like this. Instead, mark 1/2 inch below the center of the original line and create the arc. Use a pin to transfer the underarm point to the back and mark 2 inches from the center back. Create and adjust the armhole in the same manner as the front. Because the front and the back are not identical, it is important to cut them separately. Here, I'm creating a 1/2 inch seam allowance from the neckband, but I recommend using a 1 inch because you might need some extra fabric later on. You can use a 1/2 inch for the rest of the top. Cut through the seam allowance of the neckband and remove any top stitching from the neckband. Cut out 4 1-inch strips with 2 that are equal to the front armhole and 2 equal to the back armhole. I like to make mine a little bit longer just to have some extra fabric in case I need it. Fold in 1/2 and attach. Fold the seam away from the edge and sew to hold it in place. We're going to hide this little oddball by creating a new seam between the shirt and the neckband. Pin and sew 1/8 inch away from the original seam. Fold the new seam towards the neckband. For the parts of the neckband that are not connected to the shirt, use the remainder of the seam allowance to cover up the raw edge. This is where the 1-inch seam allowance might come in handy if you need extra fabric. I decided to sew 2 lines along my neckband. Sew the side seams together and attach the trimming to the hem. Your project is complete. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And let me know if you would like to see more revamping DIY videos like this. Until next time, this is Momo and I'm checking out. Bye!